Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys about margins in CSS. So let's get into it. Well, let's begin with margins. Margins are used to create space around an element, and it can be easy to mix up margins with padding because they both perform a similar task. So to begin, let's add some sample text to our webpage. Let's create a heading. I'll use an H1 heading, and I will write down margin demo, and let's close this. And we'll probably want a sample paragraph. If you're using Sublime Text, you can just type in lorem, hit tab, and I am going to surround this with a pair of paragraph tags. So we need an opening paragraph tag and a closing paragraph tag. I'm also going to give this paragraph tag a unique ID, and I'm just going to call this P1. We're going to have a few different paragraphs, and we'll name each of these like P1, then P2, and P3, and we'll follow that order. And we're going to line these all up differently depending on the margins that we set. Let's save this, reload the page, and here is our sample text. Let's go to our style sheet and just make a few changes. So let's add a border around each of these elements, because with a border, it's going to be much easier to see the difference between padding and margins. So let's make some changes to our H1 heading. Let's add a border that is 1 pixel thick and is solid. And perhaps I'll give this a width too, so maybe 300 pixels. And let's target all paragraph elements. We'll also give this a border. 1 pixel is good, and we'll make this solid. And let's give this a width as well, maybe 250 pixels. All right, let's see what this looks like. And now we have a border around our H1 header tag and our paragraph tags. So let's add some padding just so we can see the difference between padding and margins. So within our paragraph tag, we're going to add some padding using the padding property, and 25 pixels should work for this. So remember that padding is the distance between an item within an element and where a border would be. So think of it like you're receiving a package. Like, think of this like a box. This is your item that you're receiving in your package, like you're receiving it in the mail. And the padding is like the bubble wrap or the styrofoam that's keeping your item safe when it's being shipped. And margins are the distance from an HTML element to other HTML elements or the edge of the browser window. So let's add a margin around our paragraph element. So we'll just type that here, margin, and then we can add maybe 25 pixels. So this will add space around all sides of an element that has a margin. And you can see that after we reloaded the web page, we now have extra space around this paragraph element. So that's the main difference between padding and margins. Padding is the distance from an item within an element to where the border would be, and the margin is the distance from where the border would be to either other HTML elements or the edge of the web browser. And if you were to take a look on your web page, you'll probably notice that there's a little bit of spacing at the top of your web page and on the left-hand side. So there's already some margin already on your HTML document. So it is possible to use negative margins to pull items in closer together. So what we'll do here is that we'll target the HTML tags, and we're going to add a negative margin. And you can also specify a specific side. So we can just say the margin at the top, and we can give this negative 21 pixels. And that should be just enough to pull this to the very top of the web browser window. Now we still have this margin on the left-hand side. So to target that, we'll just type in margin dash left. And that is about negative 8 pixels. So after adding negative margins, we can actually pull HTML elements closer together too. If I were to take this margin within the paragraph tag and I switch this to negative 25, this would actually begin to overlap, but I don't like that, so I'm going to change it back to what it was originally with 25 pixels for the margin. So that's a very basic way of adding margins to an HTML element. You just use the margin property and the amount of space that you want to surround this HTML element with. So let's create a few different examples with different techniques to add margins. So this time I'm going to target the P1 tag, and I'm just going to move a few things around. So I'm just going to move this margin to the P1 tag. And I think I'll keep this the same then, so this should be the same. All right, so let's take our paragraph, our first one. We're going to copy this, and we're going to change P1 to P2 for the second paragraph. And this time, we're going to target the P2 ID. So we can add margins to different borders around an HTML element. We kind of did that with the negative margins that we had. So with P2, let's target the top. Maybe we'll add 25 pixels. There's margin dash right, maybe 75 pixels. Margin dash bottom, 25 pixels again. You don't have to use the same numbers that I do. Feel free to change these if you want. And margin dot left, or margin dash left, 75 pixels. Okay, let's see what this looks like. Yeah, and you can see there's a little more spacing on the left-hand side and the right-hand side, but not so much on the top or bottom because we only gave ourselves 25 pixels worth of margin compared to the left and the right that has 75. So there's an alternative way to write this that's shorthand. So I'm actually going to write a note here that says, this is the same. So a shorthand way of writing all this is that you just type in the margin property, and then we're going to list four fields here. The first is the amount of pixels for the top. Second is for the right-hand side, so margin right. Then third is the bottom. And the fourth is the left. So this is the exact same thing as what we did up here, just in less steps. So this would look exactly the same as what we had originally too. Let's create another paragraph for our next example. I'm going to copy our P2 paragraph, paste it, and we'll change the ID to P3. Let's save, reload the page. All right, now this is the one that we want to add margins to. So on our CSS sheet, we're going to target the P3 ID. And we can also list a percentage for a margin. For example, we can list maybe 10%. Now, the margin is going to change depending on the size of the browser window. So currently it's set to 10%. If we were to change this to maybe 20, you can see that the change is going to be more drastic and it's going to adjust dynamically depending on the size of the window. Let's create another paragraph. So I'm going to copy this and we'll create a P4 ID. Let's save that. And we'll type in number sign P4. All right, so you can also have your paragraph or other HTML element have an automatic margin. So for example, if we typed in margin dash left and set this to auto, what would happen is that this element would actually stick to the right-hand side. But I think our previous paragraph is actually messing with its positioning, so I'm going to comment this out for now. All right. So yeah, you can see here that this paragraph is now sticking to the right-hand side because we set margin left to auto. So it's going to stay on the right-hand side no matter what the size of the browser window is. And likewise, we can do the same thing for a margin right auto. It would stick to the left-hand side. And let's change this to P5. And we'll copy our P4 paragraph and change this to P5. Okay, now the P5 paragraph is sticking to the left-hand side of our browser window. Lastly, we can have margin just set to auto, and let's use this for a P6 paragraph tag. So margin auto, and this will vertically center an HTML element. So let's copy this paragraph and paste it, and then we're going to change the ID to P6. So let's save this and reload the page. Now this is our P6 paragraph. And both the left and the right margins are set to auto. So this will stay in the center of your web page. It'll vertically stay centered no matter how large the browser window is then. So a lot of people like to do this. They set their margins to auto, so this will stay in the middle of the web page. Well, that's the basics of margins in CSS. If you would like a copy of all the markup that we worked on today, I'll post this in the comments down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that is the basics of margins in CSS. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.